sir. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Jeevani from the Department of Aeronautical Engineering. And me with my co-authors, Dilshan Kasir and Havikeshwar Vikramasinghe, are happy to present our research on analysis of test section flow conditions of low-speed wind tunnel. This will be the content of my presentation today. A wind tunnel is a basic apparatus, as most of you may know, which will help us to analyze the flow conditions on over different bodies. So it is very useful to analyze flow properties and also do various measurements on forces acting on bodies which interact with flow. And in doing so, what we do is we test a model inside a wind tunnel test section. So often it is not possible to relate all the exact conditions of the full scale model to the scale body. So in that case, through geometric similarity and also trying to match various similarity parameters such as Mach number and Reynolds number, we can achieve some accurate data with regard to the full scale body. One of the very significant problems that occur when we do these kind of experiments is a growth of a ground layer inside the test section, because it is an enclosed space and there is a solid boundary. The ground layer might sometimes cause disturbances to the potential of free stream flow. And also because of this, there might be a pressure variation inside the test section which is sometimes unknown to the tester. So the information on these exact flow properties and flow variations inside the test section are not always exactly available. That information is not available, especially in the case of the wind tunnel available at KU. So this research is the first step in analyzing the exact flow conditions and flow properties inside the test section of the wind tunnel. And many research has been done like this on similar wind tunnels, but on, not on our wind tunnel. So this is the experimental setup, which is the low-speed educational wind tunnel available at KDU, which is manufactured and designed by Aerolab USA. And it can handle flow speeds ranging from 4.5 to 65 meters per second. The turbulence level is less than 0.2%. And the test section is, it has dimensions of 2 feet in length, and height of 1 foot and a width of 1 foot. So this is a flow, open loop test section wind tunnel which has a closed test section. This is the basic methodology that we followed in this research. So first of all, we did a speed calibration to map the exact flow conditions in the velocity with the fan speed. And we did measurements of horizontal pressure variation inside the test section. And measurements of boundary layer properties were obtained for three different fan speeds, namely 500, 1000 and 1500 RPM. So for the speed calibration, we simply used the classical Bernoulli's equation, which is very simple for steady inseed flow. And the pressure measurement, which is the basic difference between the total pressure and static pressure through that, which is obtained through liquid manometers, we were able to obtain the velocities for different fan speeds. So in this, we used the pitot-static tube, which is available in the wind tunnel. It has six static orifices and has a round lip. So the specialty about the round lip is that it gives very less errors, especially with respect to flow angularities. This is the result that we got for four runs for the RPM variation from around 4000 to 1500. So by that we were able to get a plot that would give us a standard calibrated value for the flow speed. We also measured the pressure variations in the longitudinal, the perpendicular direction to the flow. So that the z direction is basically perpendicular to the flow. And this is the dynamic pressure variation and the static pressure variation. variation is basically shown, the variation from the midpoint or the center line of the tunnel. So it can be seen that the dynamic pressure is a maximum at the center line, whereas the static pressure is minimum, and it grows towards the walls. So the bound, as I mentioned earlier, the bound layer is a region which is very adjacent to the walls, which is a region of retarded flow than the free stream velocity. So because of this, the free stream or the stream tube is facing some deflections, or the undisturbed flow is reduced because of the presence of the bound layer. So for laminar bound layers over flat plate, the simplified solution can be expressed. The bound layer thickness can be expressed in terms of the Reynolds number and the distance along the flow. The displacement thickness is another important parameter to analyze. It is the distance from the stream line just outside the bound layer and how much it is deflected from the wall due to the effect of the bound layer. So that also can be expressed in a simplified solution in terms of distance along the flow x and the Reynolds number. Next, we consider the momentum thickness, which is a thickness which is basically an index that is proportional to the displacement of momentum due to the presence of the bound layer. And that also can be again expressed in a simplified solution in terms of flow Reynolds number, local Reynolds number, and the distance along the flow. So in this experiment, we used a device called a bound layer mouse, which will give us the properties of the bound layer. It is basically a series of total heads, which have either oval or flat openings. And in our tunnel, we have flat tubes, and we can obtain the velocity gradient by an adequate resolution because these tubes are placed less than their body diameter, so that we can get a very good resolution for the velocity gradient in the bound layer. So this is an actual picture of our bound layer mouse, and it is mounted on a flat plate. But in this experiment, we took the mouse out of the flat plate and mounted it on different places in the test section and obtained our readings. This is the bound layer growth at the beginning of the test section for the three different RPMs. This is the bound layer, the velocity in the bound layer at a constant small height above the surface. So the height in consideration here is 0.06 millimeters above the surface, and readings were obtained throughout the section. So basically 0 to 0.6 represents the entire length of the test section, the flow length along the flow direction. So somewhere after the midsection, there's a drop in the velocity which shows the transition has occurred around that region. So we obtained bound layer readings of readings on bound layer for the surface of the test section, which is just the surface of the test section, and also the wall of the test section. So this is showing us how the bound layer display thickness is changing for the three different RPMs. The wall of the test section, the side walls of the test section have a divergence to compensate for bound layers. So that is the yellow line shows the test section divergence. So even though the test section is diverging, we can see that the bound layer thickness is higher than the test section divergence. This shows the variation of displacement thickness. Again, as far as the wall is concerned, the divergence of the wall does not compensate for the displacement thickness. This is the variation of momentum thickness for the surface and the wall. And in this case, of course, we can see that the side wall divergence is higher, so that the effect of the momentum thickness is minimal on the potential flow. So we calculated the percentage reduction of the stream due downstream of the flow. So this was calculated for the end of the test section. So at the different RPMs, we calculated how much of percentage was lost due to these different thicknesses. So it was seen that at 1500 RPM, the effect was minimal, and also minimal effect was there due to the momentum thickness as far as the surface is concerned. For the wall, we obtained the corrected values, that is by adding the test section divergence at different points, so that we saw the effect of the momentum thickness was actually not there, because we got negative values, which means it does not have an effect on the undisturbed flow. So that those were the results that we generated during this research. So it was seen that the clean section, clean test section, that is without any models mounted, the clean section free stream velocity varies in the streamwise direction, and also the pressure variation perpendicular to the flow was obtained, the variation perpendicular to the flow, and we obtained that we also saw that the actual flow area reduction was there due to the boundary layer properties, and it was estimated a percentage was obtained so that it can be used for as a reference for different experiments that will be conducted on the wind tunnel. And more or less the error percentage of results taken at midsection are negligible. So whatever results that are taken at midsection do not have the effect of these boundary layer thicknesses. As future work, we hope to extend our work to obtain more, to conduct more analysis on the flow properties, especially in the case of obtaining the turbulence levels inside the test section. And also we would like to see the effect of streams on the flow velocity, flow quality, and to see the exact variation of dynamic pressure throughout the test section, and also to see how much of solid blockage is created with different models mounted inside the test section. So that is the end of my presentation. Thank you.
Different flow conditions
how much of turbulence is there inside the wind tunnel.
Any more questions? Please stop.
Thank you very much.